Hello.
Hi. I'm Victor, and I'm part of the team of Retri Making Projects. Retri is a social cooperative that, in addition to helping social organizations to obtain and manage projects, also develops in own inclusive educational projects, most of them European. Before starting the presentation, I would like to apologize for my English level, but I will try to do my best. In this presentation, we are going to tell you about two Erasmus Plus projects that we have developed with the participation of Aniridia Europe. The first one is looking out for a school for all, early educational inclusion for students with low vision, and the second one, seeing the invisible, inclusive digitalization of students with low vision in school education. Okay, we are going to start with looking out for a school for all. This is co-funded by Erasmus Plus program. And in this project, the partner organization are Retri Making Projects. ALBA is the Spanish Association of Support People with Albinism. Smallcodes is a computer programming social company. And Aniridia Europe, Aniridia Italiana, and Aniridia North. The purpose of this project is to facilitate the social and educational inclusion of students with visual impairments in earliest stage of school education, especially during the pre-primary education. The project provides learning methodologies, tools, and materials to adapt education to these early stages to children with visual impairments. And it has the aim of developing materials and tools to facilitate the inclusion of visually impaired children in early education, as well as digital training materials for teachers. The main objectives of this project is has created a high-impact European network of entities, experts, families, members, and beneficiaries to work in the fields of pre-primary education and educational inclusion through an intersectional association. And we have two high-quality results. The first one is the virtual training course for the training of pre-primary education teachers and the schools in the inclusion of students with visual impairments in their classroom. And the second one is an original ECT tool for the inclusion of students with visual impairments in classroom. This project has had a duration of 3 years, ending on August 31, 2022. During its implementation, 4 transnational meetings were held, are meetings to coordinate the work in which all the partner organizations of the project participate in Spain, Norway, Italy, and Spain again. Plus, also 3 multiplier events, activities to disseminate the results of the project. And we had in Spain, Norway, and Italy. Here we can see the 2 results of the project, the virtual training course for the training of pre-primary education teachers and the schools in the inclusion of students with visual impairments in their classroom, and the original ECT tool for the inclusion of students with visual impairments in their classrooms. The first one is a high-quality online training course for the training of pre-primary education teachers, focus on offering essential training and developing the skills necessary to achieve the educational inclusion of students with low vision. This course aims to provide pre-primary education teachers and the school with the possibility of acquiring, updating, completing, or expanding the knowledge and the skills on attention to diversity, and especially in case of students with visual impairment, for their personal and professional development. The course is mainly aimed at teachers from pre-primary education centers, so they can transform their classroom into inclusive environments for children with visual impairment. This course is freely accessible and free of charge. It's taught through the e-learning platform Virtually Inclusive Education, and it offers a dynamic, flexible and autonomous training. And also, when a user finishes the course, he or she can get a certificate, a digital badge. Okay, the learning program of this course is composed for 10 didactic units structured in 3 blocks. So, for example, the block one, I'm sorry, it's in Spanish, this image, but in the block one, teacher training plan for development of the perceptual, sensory, psychomotor, cognitive, affective, emotional, communication, language, and social areas for the beneficiaries in a standard course. And for example, we have the unit 2, understanding the low vision, unit 3, low vision in the pre-primary classrooms, unit 4, new technologies as means of inclusion in the classroom, etc. The second result of the project is VSAP. It's an early stimulation game for the inclusion of low vision children. This is an innovative ECT tool focused on promoting the effective inclusion of children with mild or severe visual impairment in ordinary classroom for pre-primary stage. The main objective of this app is to serve as support material for visual and cognitive stimulation of children with visual impairment from 0 to 6 years old. However, it's not planned exclusive for use of students with special need. As a tool, it's conceived as a mechanism for inclusion in equity. So, it is a resource to have been used by all the students, which promotes, in addition to the sensory perceptive development of the children and the stimulation of creative group work, socialization among all the students, so the collaborative work. VSAP is an interactive application especially designed for use by teachers in the classroom and families at home, which is why it's compatible with a large number of devices. VSAP is easily downloadable, freely accessible, and a free application. It can be used in the Android environment and is compatible with iOS devices. It is structured as a progressive learning system. The contents and the games of the app are divided into blocks of learning itineraries depending both the age and the objectives achieved. Each of these itineraries has 6 types of games. Also, to facilitate the use of the app, we create a guide. Is the Early Stimulation Program for Children with Low Vision User's Guide. And this guide describes the main characteristics of the game, like the level, the objectives of each game, how to prepare the activity, its work methodology, the criteria of evaluation, etc. And if you want more information about this project, you can check the website of the project, this is schoolforall.eu. And lastly, we must point out that this project was recently selected as an example of good practice by the Spanish Service of Internalization of the Education, SEPIE, which is the Erasmus Plus National Agency in Spain. And this recognition that this project is one of the best in Spain in terms of quality, implementation, and results. And now we will present the second project, the Seeing the Invisible, Inclusive Digitalization of Students with Low Vision in School Education. This project is being developed by the same organization as the previous one, plus a new organization, Greta Dubelet, is an association of public educational centers in France, and we participate Retri, ALBA, Smallcot, and Iride Europa, Italiana, and Norge, like the last project. This project will generate a digital and adaptive tools to help any school's education students with low vision to achieve full inclusion in the classroom and educational success, regardless of whatever the teaching on-site or online. In this way, this project is complementary to the previous one, but in this case is aimed at the last years of primary education and the first years of secondary education. This project is currently in its implementation stage. It has a length of 2 years, starting on November 1st, 2021, and ending on November 1st, 2023. We will have 4 transnational meetings too, in Spain, Italy, Norway, and France. And we held the first transnational meeting this past May in Valencia, in Spain. And we will have 3 multiplier events in Spain, Italy, and Norway, and other kind of activities, like activities for the creation of materials, regular meeting, pilot test, dissemination, and evaluation activities. The main objectives of this project are providing teachers with specific training about low vision to allow them to understand the abilities of their students, the consequences of their rare disease and low vision, and to learn about the effective teaching process adapted to this group of beneficiaries. Promoting an inclusive, innovative, and adapted appealing schools education for students, both with and without low vision. Promote the use of adapted digital materials that facilitate teaching and avoid having to rebuild all the teaching materials created for on-site teaching over the years. Promote the active participation of experts, doctors, and family members of school students with low vision in the work of the teacher. And realize awareness in the educational community on the importance of adapting schools to people with low vision. Here we have the 3 results of this project. The first result is Seeing the Invisible, the educational application for the inclusive digitalization of the classroom through the smartphone. The second one is Virtual Training Course for Teachers, Inclusive Digitalization in School Education. And the third one, open Educational Resources Adapted to Students with Low Vision. The first one, the Seeing the Invisible, Education Application for the Inclusive Digitalization of the Classrooms of the Smartphone, is a software for Android and iOS, which will allow them to teach their classes directly through their students' devices and in format completely adapted to the people with low vision. It's aimed to at primary and secondary teachers when they must implement blended or remote modalities for young people with low vision and rare disease. It will serve to generate a support network among the teachers who share they adapted documents and exchange experiences. This APP will allow the teacher to design and generate the didactic units of their subject, as well as the sessions that compose it, in a totally virtual format and guide through the DU Builder. Generate virtual classrooms where the generate session will appear automatically, and you can teach them synchronously or asynchronously. involve the students with low vision and desperate in the learning progress, and have an adversarial system so that teachers who have students with low vision can turn into experts. The second result is the virtual training course for teachers, inclusive digitalization in school education. This is a virtual course designed at teachers of pre-primary and secondary education, and it's intended to provide them with necessary knowledge and methodology so they can teach their lessons adapted to the needs of students with low vision. Among these contents, we can highlight the Unit 3, Low Vision and Rare Disease and Iridian Albinism, the Unit 5, Guidelines for Working with Primary and Secondary School Students with Low Vision, Unit 8, the Role of Teachers in the Inclusive Learning in Equity, Unit 11, Inclusion in Equity Through Digitalization, Educational Methodology, and 14, Creation of Didactic Programs Adapted to Low Vision. And the last result of this project is the Open Educational Resources Adapted to Students with Low Vision. Are open, digital, and completely adapted educational resources that teachers can use directly in the classroom or simply modify them. These open educational resources will have a flexible format that will allow them to work online through computers, tablets, smartphones, but also offline. Inclusive digitalization methodology proposed so they can be used simultaneously with the rest of materials in the development of the classes where normal 8 and low vision students participate in equity. And here we have the role of each partner in this project. RETRI is the coordinator of the project and the content of the first result. Smallcoach is responsible for the computer coordination of the results. Greta Duvele is advised test and dissemination of the three outputs. Alba is responsible for the output 3, advised test and dissemination. And Aniridia Italiana, Aniridia Norway and Europe, advice, test, and dissemination of the three outputs. So we have already finished the presentation of the second project. And now, before finishing and moving on to the questions, we want to briefly name another project that we also are working on. Is educational inclusion into diversity, facing school living, innovative methodologies to support ethnic minority students and to stop hate speech in Europe. This project is also aimed to create more inclusive schools, but in this case by putting a stop to the hate speech and bullying. We have created a large number of educational resources to fight against the possible discrimination suffered by all the students with obstacles in the classroom. The results we believe you might be most interested in those are related with disabling, the discrimination against people with disabilities. Here we have an example. This is a training poster, but we also have created activities, surveys, and didactic units, etc. And with this, we finish the presentation, and we are at your disposal in case you have any questions. Thank you.